everyone, please, attention. Yes. Can we give a mighty clap to our living God, please? Are we all blessed that we are here?
Amen.
Amen. And tonight we are going to thank God for the life of Mommy Lynn. Amen. The praise and worship goes to our living God through because of His faithfulness to the servant of Him. Amen. Through the life of Mommy Lynn. And to start with, amen. Blessed and happy birthday, Mommy Lynn. But we will focus on something else, and later on we will come back to you. So we'll go and proceed now. May we call on Brother Lito to open us in opening prayer.
Praise the Lord, church. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are we all blessed?
Amen. Amen.
Can we give a mighty hand of praise to our living God? We deserve all the praises and honor. Amen. For the life of each, everyone, and of course, for His faithfulness to our birthday celebrants. Amen?
Amen.
Are you excited tonight?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Can we please bow our head and close our eyes, and we will start in prayer. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank You. We honor You, Lord God, for You are a faithful God. Lord, Your love never fails.
Amen.
Your promises are true. Oh, hallelujah, Lord God. Thank You, Lord, for the gift of salvation. Thank You, Lord, for the gift of life. Thank You, Lord, for the forgiveness of our sins, Lord God. Thank You, Lord, for Your provisions that abound in Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, merciful and gracious God, Lord, You deserve all the honor and praises, Lord God. And tonight, oh Lord God, as we open this, Lord, in prayer, Lord, we pray. We welcome the Holy Spirit in our midst. Holy Spirit, You will be our director, oh Lord God. And we pray that whatever we're going to do tonight, Lord God, Lord, it will bring glory unto Your holy name, Lord God. Thank You, Father God, Lord, and even the words, oh Lord God, that, Lord, will be shared by Your servants, and even the music, oh Lord God, that we're going to sing to You, Lord God. Lord, let this be a sweet aroma before Your throne, acceptable, Lord God, to You. Hallelujah. May Your name be lifted up and be glorified, Lord God. We thank You, Lord God, and even, Lord, we thank You, Lord, for the lives of Your servants, the pastors, the workers, the leaders who are present in this church, oh, Lord God, even the members, Lord, we thank You, oh God, for their lives. Lord, as Lord, Apostle Peter, oh, Lord God, says, Lord, the elders who directs, oh, Lord God, the church, oh, Lord God, Lord, deserve a double portion of honor, oh, Lord God, especially those who are in teaching and preaching ministry. Oh, hallelujah. We thank You, Father God. And we pray, oh Lord God, Lord, whatever we're going to do, Your name only be lifted up. We thank You and we bless You. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. A blessed evening, everyone. Happy birthday, our dearest Mommy Lynn. We love you very much. But we are gathered in this place not just to celebrate the life of our dearest Mommy Lynn, but of course to also worship our living God. Amen. So hindi na to mawawala sa atin. Talagang we are gathered in this place to have fellowship with one another, and most especially to have fellowship with our living God. Amen. So can we just give the Lord a big clap of praise for what He has done? Presence. Amen. I know most of us are tired from our workplaces, from the travel, from the rush hour traffic. So now we are here to just enjoy God's presence. Amen. Hallelujah. Most gracious and loving Father, we thank You. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, we bless You, Holy Name. Right now, God, we just enjoy Your presence. We enjoy, God, the sweet fellowship with You, Lord. Hallelujah. Indeed, Lord, your love, God, has changed us. The power of your love, O Lord, has changed us. We are now a new creation, renewed by you, Lord. And so right now, with our whole hearts, we worship you. Hallelujah, we worship you. Oh, we worship you, come on, church. We worship you, Abba Father. Oh, we worship you. Come on, let's utter songs of worship. Let's utter songs of praise. Let's utter songs of thanksgiving to our living God. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, we worship you.
Thank you. Pastor Mark,
We have Pastor Alice, of course. Good evening. And Pastor Jess and his wife. Where's Pastor Jess? Seats are available po in front. And we have from GIC, our Pastor Ronald. Amen. Pastor Ronald. Pastor Ronald, the church is calling you here. And Pastor Wayne from GIC. And we have Pastor Hazel also. Pastor Hazel, good evening. We have from Gia Sakwa, Pastor Dan. Amen. And of course, our youth pastor, Pastor Sharon. There she know, okay. And we have from GWF, Pastor Evan and his wife. Pastor, yo. Amen. Good evening po. Sister Mahek, of course. Amen. Pastor Ryan and wife and lovely children. Amen. Welcome. Of course, we have also on the... Amen. Anyone there? And we have Pastor Sam and his wife from Faith Hope Love Church. Pastor Bon and wife, wife Honey from URL. Good evening. And we have from Gia Sadwa, Pastor Michelle. Amen. And praise God. We are full house from also Gia Sadwa, Pastor Bas, and Pastor Anna. Amen. Pastor Jairo, where? Pastor Jairo, please. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10 chairs po are here. And Pastor Ryan, of course.
Amen.
Amen. Welcome po. Pastor Bong and B from Jayadera as well. Please. Pastor Nipa from Jayadera as well. And do you know that aside from Mami Lin, there's also one pastor celebrating his birthday? Pastor Abo! And his wife. Amen? And? Okay, there are more here. Please bear with me. We have Pastor Grace and Jerome from URL. And of course, our own Pastor Marlon and Pastor Erlene. They're here. If I need somebody, please. Pastor Andre, of course. And there's some more brethren of us who are on the way. So without much ado, may I call, please? And of course, we will not miss. Kuya Pabes! Of course! Amen? Because he will be called later. That's why. Amen?
Are you all excited to hear the word of God?
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Can you please tap somebody and tell them that I'm so blessed?
I'm so blessed.
Because the presence of God is here. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. So I would like to introduce the messenger for tonight, none other than our Pastor Babesh. One of the members of BOE and also active in the body of Christ. Church, join your hands together and let's welcome Pastor Babesh Nasta.
I know Mommy is very surprised. Actually, it came to our mind, you know, and to be very honest, because of so many things, I forgot completely from my mind that 28 is Tuesday and I already had in heart to do something. And then she's asking, oh, what is it Tuesday? What is it? It's a Highway 19 meeting. Is there? And I'm the preacher. So she said, you're missing something, I said. Then I realized that I messed something. And I said, okay, mom, nothing. So I sent message to the highway team. I will cancel the team and we will have something surprise. Right? Such a joy it is for everyone to join. You know, if I have an option to bring everyone, I can ask everyone to join. But because of the limited of the place and everything. First of all, I just like to thank the Lord Jesus Christ for the life of Mommy Lynn. Right? And if Mommy Lynn is not come in our life especially, I will be not standing here. Right? It's very important to that understand that 70 years that she's been, but that life of 70 years is not the life that she was having, an easy life. Right? Bible says in the book Proverbs 30:31, honor the woman who has need to be honored, right? Yes. And that's what it happens. She is the woman of Proverbs 31:31. She will honor her. She doesn't require anything. She doesn't want to have any celebration or anything. She just wanted to be just with the family. And suddenly the family also came. Last Friday afternoon she was shocked because her daughter and then son-in-law walked in from Germany straight. Oh. And she was shocked. She was getting ready to go to one anniversary and then she decided not to go because they are at the door. And then 26, the youngest son also came in from India, Warren, and she's also surprised that he's also here. Right? And they all, the other two cannot come. Brother Harold cannot come because of restrictions, and Sister Simone cannot come because of many restrictions in their country. But they are feeling bad. But more important that, in these 70 years, Mommy has a big, big family. She has not only five biological children, or a son-in-law, a daughter-in-law, and plus the grandchildren, but she has hundreds and thousands of people that she's been. They call Mommy Lynn. Mommy Lynn become a brand name in UAE, right? Because her name is, original name is Patricia Madeline Rowe, right? And because everyone used to call her in India Auntie Lynn Lynn, so when they came here, so I introduced her because of the habit, this is Mommy Lynn. So everybody got Mommy Lynn, right? And then she became a name, Mommy Lynn, and not only in the GSLA community UAE, but in the whole body of Christ, she is known as a Mommy Lynn there, right? Now, I just don't want to preach here because this is a celebration time, but I just wanted to say something. The life of Mommy Lynn was not easy. At the age of 12, she lost her mother. And from the age of 12, she was put into the kitchen. And till this 70 years, she's still in the kitchen cooking for us. And so happy that she cooks good food, right? That's why we are so healthy. How many people believe Mommy Lynn's biryani is best? Now, she started their life there because her mom died and she got married at the age of 18 or 19 and then her father died. Okay, she has another one and then though definitely she was married, but at the age of 29, her husband, like our father, died. Right? Shock after shock. Now she has five children, fifth was inside the stomach, Warren, and Mommy was in shock. And from that day, 29 years old, she got such a stroke of her blood pressure fluctuated, and from 41 years, she has this blood pressure in her life. Life was not easy. She has five children plus us, myself, my siblings also, plus another people also, always with Mommy in the house. And for me, when I was 7 years, I was it might be like I was vomiting or blood, or maybe I might get it, tuberculosis is a second sign that I was getting, and I was neglected. And that hug that she gave me at the age of 7, that embraced me in the love that she has for us. And from that day, you know, I become so attached to Mommy. I said, Mom, yes, I have a biological mom who gives birth, but someone who raised you up also has a great responsibility, right? She raised me up. She brought me to Christ also, right? We are her Timothys actually, and today, if whatever I'm standing here, or whatever people respect, or everything that we receive, yes, God is doing great things in our life, it's God who does it, but there is someone also behind that who helps us, right? And that's Mommy Lynn, right? The life that I have seen her, like working, she worked so hard when she was young, 29 years old, she lost her husband, she used to go 5 a.m. in the house, leaving the children home with pregnant, and she used to come 5, 7 p.m. in the evening, then cook for the children, everything, life was not, we were staying in a rented house, the house was leaking and everything was going, such a thing that happened in her life, that a life was completely shattered. at the age of 29. And then all things happened. She even took the job of a nurse. She should work as a tailor. She works as a school teacher. She works as a principal. Whatever she can get just to give food to us. But in 70 years of her life, she has never begged a single rupee with anyone, because that was the grace that God has given her.
Yes.
She never went on the door to ask someone. If she has 8 pieces of bread and we have 12 people, she will cut it and give it equally. If she have one chocolate that we get, someone gives a gift as a chocolate, she will cut equally and give us. And that's what she has equally loved all of us. She has never differentiated her love to the children. But the turning point came 1993 when we received Jesus Christ. And she also received the same day, we all received the Jesus Christ. We received the baptism at the same time. And 1995 onwards, her life become, Jesus become her husband and Father God becomes her father. You know, Bible says, I am the husband of the widow and I am father of the fatherless. And she made Jesus the God upon her life, and there was no turning back. The miracle started in her life. Miracle started in her life. Children started to work. We all said, Mom, now you don't need to work. We will be working now. And then eldest daughter, the second daughter, the second youngest daughter, she got the scholarship. She went to America. Brother Lee or Harold came to UAE. And we all came to UAE in 95, 94, 95, 96, 98. And life started to change for all of us. Now, journey for her is not easy, right? Even sometimes when I see that she sleeps on the bed alone, I feel, Lord, at least you have there with us, you know, in all the times. We don't know what she goes, what she thinks, what is happening in mind, but she's still there and she always praises God. She made Jesus her husband, and then there was no turning back. We tried to get her to say, Mama, if you get someone to get married, she said, no, I have married my Jesus. So I will be with my Jesus, right? And Jesus became everything to her, and today she's become a great woman of God, where God has made her, right? And I know that every one of you experienced her in her life. Every one of you are sitting in this room, you have personally experienced Mama Lynn in your life. And that's what Mama Lynn is all about, it is, right? And today the children are also there, they will be coming a little late. And we celebrated her. And then I told her that we are just going to Al Khoury Hotel and maybe we have some service there, you know. So she was, in the back of mind, is happening something. And then suddenly the phone rang and Gemma said, don't ring her 5 minutes and we'll talk to her. And this phone rings big, not the voice big. And she heard it something. And then she said, something is there anyway. But she was here. Now what I wanted to say, we love you all, everyone. We wanted to celebrate the 70 years with you all.
Yeah.
Right? Because you are all become a part of our family in this journey. Right? Yes, we have biological family. We celebrated with them yesterday, but we wanted to celebrate with you all because last 15 years, we have been with you, you have been with us, and you are all become the part, not only the God's family, but the part of our family also. We consider everyone as our own in our life. And that's why we decided to just, let's celebrate Mommy's 70th birthday together. It's not about her birthday, she's never interested to celebrate the birthday. But interesting is that we wanted to give thanks to the Lord Jesus Christ, that without any problem in her life, she completed 70 years.
Yay. Yeah.
She completed 70 years. Recently, when she took the second dose of Pfizer, and then she was having some complications, though she was affected with the COVID in last time, but it's not actually COVID, but it just virus that happened. But when she took the second dose, she was feeling some uneasiness from last 2 weeks' time. She was feeling headache and all these things. She was getting tired and sleepy. So I said, well, let's go to the doctor at least and get ruled out what it is, you know. So we just went to one doctor, and the doctor said, let her take all the tests again, because this is a post-COVID test, so let's rule out what it is. So we took all the tests, whatever needed, 55 blood tests, x-ray, everything, even vitamin D tests, everything was taken. And after 2 days, we went to the doctor. She's sitting, the reports have come, she's sitting with the red pen to mark what is the problem in her report. And she couldn't find anything to mark there. She couldn't find anything, and she was surprised when she looked at her. And that lady, the doctor also had the same rough life like what she has. You know, she was also sharing to each other. And then she said, Mama, it's better that you go to cardiologist, you know. So we know one cardiologist, his name is Dr. Jason. She is sitting. I said, we know him very well because he's our church member and we know him. yes, he said, better go ahead and visit him. So I sent the message to Dr. Jason that time, and he said, mommy is having some breathing problem. He said, bring her immediately. I'm here in the Esther hospital. So we brought her to the Esther. She took everything. He went and he took again some ECG. He saw all the report and everything. Then he gave some one medicine. He said, try this one medicine for one day. Maybe the people will, blood pressure will calm down. And she took it. And after 5 days, again, we went there. So again, he went there. He took the one ECG. And then he got the ECG report. And we were in his cabin. He got up and he went and locked the room. I thought that he has something serious to say. But no, he just locked the room. He sat down and he prayed with us. And he prayed for mommy. And then you know what he said? He said, mama, he calls her sister, 41 years you have this blood pressure. And that is happening. The blood pressure can kill any organ in your body. And can damage any organ in your body. But Jesus Christ has kept all organ in your body perfectly well. So don't worry about this blood pressure. Just pray, and he prayed, and we were home. And we are celebrating the Lord Jesus Christ in her life and with you, right? Because we, for us, you know, it's not the culture for that, what you call that gathering and for the birthday celebration, all these things. No, it's not that. But we decided, I personally decided to give something, mommy, and let's celebrate mommy's life with everyone. Because 70 years is the year the Lord has commanded that a man should live 70 years. Right? Are you getting it? And after that, whatever the years they live, it is the grace of God, it is the love of God. Is the way of God, right? And she's living now. She will live with us, and she will be with us, and she will be serving. So I asked her mom, what's your finally plan? Are you want to go and settle down with some children? Are you want to spend some time with the children? She turned around and said, my children are all here, and I just want to be here.
Amen.
I just want to serve here. I just wanted to serve here. And she's telling Pastor Mark, if you want to send her to Tanzania, Africa, she's ready to go. And she always says, Pastor Mark, let's go to Africa. She's always behind Pastor Mark. Let's go, Pastor Mark. I'm there to go with you. And she's there already to do that. So just want to give glory to the Lord. I just wanted to give thanks to the Lord. And just wanted to honor a person also that who has done a great sacrifice. Today, because of her sacrifice, we all children are settled in life. Because of her sacrifice and love. And we are all knitted together, you know, as a family. Even though we are living in a different part of the world, but we live very closely to each other, right? And they're also celebrating with her. Today, she has 5 children, biological children, right? And she has 2 son-in-law, 2 daughter-in-law, 6 grandchildren, and plus we are our children. So she has a big family, right? And we pray that she will see the great-grandchildren, because her eldest grandchild is almost 19 years, right? 18 years old. And by the way, he's also having a Philippine connection because his girlfriend is Filipino. Wow. So I said, mom, I think this is where God is bringing us together, and maybe this is something is going to happen, right? So we are praying that he's 18 years old, maybe another 5 years old, he will get married and he will have a child. And mommy will be able to see the great-grandchild. So what we want to do tonight is that we want you to just release your declaration of blessing upon her. We want your prayers that will be as a blessing, a declaration of blessings will be upon her life, right? So there will be a part that we will be calling, you know, if the board of elders will come. So we want all the pastors of GIUE, when board of elders are coming to pray in front, as Pastor Mike will lead, I really want that all the pastors will come, surround the mummy, or just make mummy stand in front and you stand at the back and release your declaration upon her life. Amen. So can we all ask it? So God bless you and thank you for coming.
Thank you, Pastor Robert, for a wonderful, amazing testimony in the life of Mama Jane and your family. I would like to call the attention of all the BOE of Jesus Alive Community Church and the pastors as well. Could you please come forward? Amen. But before that, I would like to acknowledge the presence of Brother Verghese, a family friend of Mama Jane and Kuya Babesh, and a member also of the Body of Christ. Amen. Pastor of Jesus Alive Community Church and the BOE. And I would like to call Pastor Mark. Pastor Mark will lead a declaration to Mommy Jane.
All the board of elders, please come in front. And all the pastors, wala na kayong choice kasi mag-pray tayo. Huwag na kayo dyan sa likod. Can I invite family? Ang mami ng bayan? Hallelujah. Mahal ba natin itong ating mami? Kung tayo ay nagmamahal sa ating mami, tayo tayong lahat at magdi-declare tayo ng blessings. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. Can we stretch our hands and release the blessing? And today, tonight, we will declare blessings. Hallelujah. Ang sabi sa Psalm 90 verse 10, 70 years daw yung ano yung isang generation. At pag malakas-lakas ka pa, abutin ka ng 80. Si Mami rin hindi ng 80. Naniniwala ba tayo dyan? Hallelujah. God will prolong her life. And God will use her mightily not only to this community but within the whole body of Christ and even to the missions. Amen. We will not only declare physical strength, protection from all harm, protection from all sicknesses, covering of the blood of Jesus. Today also we will declare that the greatest desire of her heart, not only in mission, but to lead a nation into Christ, will be fulfilled. Hindi natin alam kung dito sa UAE, but nung chinalins ko sila, especially the Board of Elders, to come into mission, to come and see what is happening outside, especially in the area of Africa, isa si Mami rin sa nag-encourage, at isa siya sa unang-unang sumagot. And last February, we were all together into mission work in Tanzania. And we are also praying that soon we will be able to reach not only Tanzania, and by the grace of God and by the great move of our Lord Jesus Christ, we were able also to reach out Uganda. And there are a lot of openings, and we are challenging everyone, not only Mami Rin. Then si Mami Rin may edad na. And yet, she is more than willing to answer the call of the Lord into mission. Yes. Hallelujah! This is a great challenge for everyone. Nigeria also, and God opened one ministry also in Nigeria because of the prayer of all the members of this community. So we are so thankful for all of you, and we would like to thank also the life of Mami Lim. She's a great encouragement to all of us. Especially the Board of Elders. Let us lift our hands and let us release and declare the blessing to our Mami Lim. Our dear Heavenly Father, we are so grateful to you. We thank you for the life of our dear Mami Lim, O Lord God. Thank you for the physical strength. Thank you for the spiritual strength that you are giving to her, O Lord God. Thank you, Lord, that she's a great encouragement not only to the Board of Elders, not only to the members of this community, O Lord God, but even to the body of Christ, O Lord, whom she knows. Father, we declare tonight, O Lord God, your anointing to be upon her, O Lord Jesus. Great anointing, O Lord Jesus, to be upon her, that as she declare your words, there will be signs and wonders. There will be miracles, O Lord God. And you will use her life, O Lord God, to declare your glory with signs and wonders and with authority, O Lord God. Father, we thank you also for her life, that you are using her not only to her own family, but also to this community, O Lord God. Today, Lord Jesus, we declare that you will prolong her life. You will add more years to her, O God. Long years of service to your kingdom, O Lord God. Protected by your blood. Protected by any viruses, O Lord God, by the blood of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you will increase the numbers of days of her life until she meets you face to face, O Lord God. We thank you, Jesus, that tonight we just release your blessing. Good health, O Lord God. Long life, O Lord Jesus. Anointing and authority to be upon her, O Lord Jesus. Father, today and tonight, And she will serve you, O Lord God, until the last breath, O Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And today as we release and declare your mighty anointing and blessing, O Lord God, we just lift her up unto thee, grant every desire of her heart. We thank you and we glorify your name. She is yours, O Lord. This is our prayer in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and all the saints of God says amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you, my name. Praise the Lord. God bless you, man. We love you. We love you.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Mark, and of course, the BOE and the pastors of Jesus Alive Community Church. Now, amen. One more. Amen. We're going to put on spotlight the body of Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. So I may call Pastor Evan Tagana to come forward together with all the pastors of body of Christ. Will you please come forward? And I would like to request to Pastor Evan to declare a blessing. Come forward, please, Pastor. In church, we will agree because there's a power in agreement, right?
Amen. Once again, can we all stand up? And thank you for the opportunity, Gia. Ever since I came here in Dubai, the second church that I came to know is Gia. So, yeah, it's always a family wherever we go. And I believe that this is a divine providence that we are all here, especially in the celebration of 70. All the body of Christ represented here, can you please come over here before I call it? Brother
Ami.
Sister Ardet. Sister Honey.
Honey. Emily.
Anyone from the back?
Yes.
Anyone from the outside? No?
The outside.
Alright, lapit ko tayo. Let's come closer. And again. And also the kids, please come. The anime. All the body of Christ. Amen. Maminin, before I pray. Mamilin. Mamilin. Too much again. Mamilin. Hi, I got the kids from Abizan. Alright. Mamilin, thank you very much. The first time we met in that dog watch in Hilly Tower B in the basement, it was a great challenge to me. During the time, with Pastor Barber, first time we saw each other, and he called me the son.
Donkey?
No, I told about the donkey, and my mom said, "You're not a donkey, you're a horse." Again, can we come closer, please? And let us also extend our hand as we, the body of Christ, leads the prayer. Hallelujah. Let's come in the presence of the Lord. Father, we thank you and we bless your holy name. Holy, holy, holy is your name. It is your holiness, Father, that you brought us all together here, O God, as we celebrate the 70th day, birthday. O Lord, in your sovereign grace, in your sovereign plan, you have watched over in the life of Mamilin. The 29th years, the first 29, was a great journey. The years ahead until now, it is your Holy Spirit is leading all the way. Father, we pray and we declare that Mamilin will be continued to be worthy of the calling that she received from her. Wherever she walks, whatever she touches, especially in the body of Christ, oh God, she will be a blessing. Father, thank you, oh God, that wherever she will speak for your word, oh God, it will bring comfort.
Amen.
It will bring exhortation.
Yes, Lord.
It will bring encouragement.
Amen.
And edification in the body of Christ.
Amen.
Lord, this is what you wanted us to do. Until we all attain the unity of faith. Father, you serve for your glory to maintain the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. Lord, she is your ambassador. Wherever she steps, wherever she moves forward, whatever nation, oh God, that you will bring into her, oh God, she will be a blessing. Father, these are the hands of the body of Christ, the hands of the church, oh God. Oh Lord, we touch your hand and release through your hand, unto our hand, the blessing coming from you. Oh Lord of heaven, thank you. We pray for what we believe, because we pray in the name of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. All for your glory, all for your name, oh Lord. We lift your name on high, Jesus, in the life of Mamelyn. And when your name is lifted up, you will draw all men unto yourself, unto her, and unto her ministry, and unto her family.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name. Once again, Lord, thank you for the 70 years and years to come.
Amen.
Lord, we declare and bless the name of your name, O Lord Jesus Christ, in the life of my name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Amen.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Pastor Eva, and the body of Christ.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Eva, and the body of Christ, as Kuya Lito mentioned. Okay. And we are going to the part of third declaration. May we call on Gia Duvay, pastors, leaders, workers, please to come in front. Let's take this opportunity, please. Gia Dubai, pastors, leaders, workers. Mommy Lee, I'm so sorry. We're going to give you a chance after this. No, we will give you the mic, Mommy. Please, please. Please come forward. Kuya Bobesh, you are also part of Gia Dubai, please. Amen. Not balance. Please po. Amen. We're all here. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. We're ready po. Mga ates, kuyas. Amen. We're going to declare, of course, the declaration. Amen. Amen po. We're ready na. Mami, would you want to come forward a little bit, please? Thank you. Amen. Shall we raise our hands, please? Hallelujah. May we call on also the attention of everyone po to be with us. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise your name, O Abba Father, in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord, with the communion of the Holy Spirit. Lord, tonight as we are celebrating, O Father God, Lord, the goodness of yours in the life of Mamelyn. Lord, we lift you, O Father God, in her life, O God. Though it's been already mentioned and, Lord, declared by our pastors from BOE and BOC, O Father God, Lord, lots of blessings, but we are, Lord, repeating everything, O Father God, because, Lord, we know that it's important, O Lord, that as we speak of your goodness towards the life of Mamelyn, Lord, we know all the things that has been mentioned, O Father God, declared will come into pass, O God, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord, because it is your will that everything will be well in your children, O God, and your servant, Mamelyn, as she's celebrating tonight. tonight, oh God. Lord, we thank you for her life, oh God, that, Lord, you are using her, oh Father God, in the ministry, oh Father God, wherein, Lord, souls are being added into your kingdom, oh God. Lord, we know, Father God, that this is not yet the last time, oh Father God, that we will be celebrating your goodness in her life, but this is, Lord, there will be another journeys, oh Father God, in her life, oh God, wherein, Lord, your goodness, Lord, your Shekinah glory will be seen unto her life, oh God. And Lord, that there will be, Lord, much extravagant anointing, oh Father God. Sign and wonders will be done, oh God, in your name, in the through the life of Manilin, oh God. Lord, we're not lifting her, but we're thanking you for all your goodness in her life, oh God. Lord, we know, Father God, that, Lord, there are a lot of things ahead of her that you already prepared, oh Father God, in advance. And we declare, oh Lord, continue, so Father God, the health, oh Father God, good health be upon her, oh God. Lord, let your shine, oh Father, your face shine on her, oh God, in the name of Jesus. That, Lord, she will continuously walk, oh Father God, Lord, in your wisdom, oh Father God, knowledge and understanding. And Lord, as she, Lord, enjoy worshiping you, oh Father God. Lord, we know that, Lord, what is in the hearts of a person, Lord, in abundance of what is in her heart, oh Lord, her lips will reveal it, oh Lord, in worshiping you, in praising you, in hymns and psalms, oh God, in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for her life, oh God, Lord, that we declare, oh Lord, that whatever she touched, wherever she stepped in, oh Lord, all the things that she will touch, oh Lord, and the place where she will step in will be blessed in the name of Jesus. And there will be a great harvest of souls for your glory, oh God, in Jesus' name. Lord, thank you for her life that you have given us, unto us, oh God, as our spiritual mother, Lord. May your joy, oh Father God, abound in her, oh Father God, as always, Lord, as she's continuously serving you, oh God. Lord, bless her, oh God, in all areas of her life, Lord, that she will be continuously a channel of blessing to others, not only physically, not only materially, but, oh Lord, spiritually, oh God, in Jesus' name. Lord, once more, we thank you for your goodness in her life, oh God, for this night, Lord, 70 years and more to come, in the name of Jesus. This is our prayer, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Okay. Now, we're going to the part where Big Chance, Mami Lin, Ate Jess, Ate Ivy, won't you mind passing Mami Lin? This is nothing, Mami. We know that you don't like to do it, but we are requesting you to please do it, to proceed on the table for slicing of the cake. And we're going to give you a chance to hold this mic, Mami Lin. Amen. Praise God.
Happy birthday.
we want to give more excitement to Mami Lynn, so please bear with us. Amen. Well, our media team prepared for us a short clip. Amen. So can we all sit, please, so we can all watch.
Kafano kekwe, kafano kekwe, kafano dinanulin, kafano kekwe.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Nanalin, happy birthday to you. Have a happy and blessed birthday, Nanalin.
Kafano kekwe, kafano kekwe, kafano dinanalin, kafano kekwe. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nanalin. Happy birthday to you. Love you, Nana. Have a happy birthday and a blessed year.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Nana. Happy birthday to you. Happy hooray!
Been dreaming of, and now I know there is nothing that I could not do. Thanks to you for teaching me how to feel, showing me my emotions, letting me know what's real from what is not. What I've got is more than I'd ever hoped. And a lot of what I've hoped for is thanks to you.
We without professions and our jobs, no, my beloved. We are called to come and build God's kingdom on this earth. Not to worry about anything. He said in Matthew 6:33, seek ye first the kingdom of God, God's righteousness. Everything will be added unto you. Amen. You know, in the churches, there are many people who have lost their jobs. And they're so worried, what would we do? But that's not it, my beloved. We should live by faith and not by sight. Amen?
Amen.
You heard Pastor Wilma speaking about faith. Do we have this faith?
Amen.
I can tell you I have it. I really tell you I know who Christ is in me. When we know that God will never forsake us, why should we be afraid? My beloved, rise up, women of God. I really tell you, I love you all so much. You know, I could do many things what I wanted to do. I could have been in many other countries today. But my beloved, as God has called us to a calling, I am here to help you to walk a closer walk with Jesus. And come and check my book. I kept on reading and pondering and writing and writing until I think 5 o'clock I got up and said, Lord, you gave it to me, I wrote it. Now you're going to speak through me, not me. Amen. Sometimes, my beloved, it is not even easy to think how God works in our life. You know, But believe me, my beloved, when God loves you, He will let you go through many things. He will test you. He will put you through the refiner's fire to purify you for His own glory. He said, I'm a jealous God. He's jealous of you. He doesn't want you to love anyone more than Him. Yes. Amen.
About time that you are the one who will give speech for us. We call on the birthday celebrants. Celebrant Mamilin.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Church, I'm really speechless. I'm so surprised today, but my heart overjoys with the love that God has given me this beautiful family. I truly tell you, I'm so shocked, but I know because of the love of the Father, and He never forsakes His children. You know, I can really stand before you and tell you the truth. This is the first time in my whole life am I celebrating my birthday like this. I know I'm shedding tears of joy, but I really want to thank you so much. But before that, I just want to encourage you. You can look at me. You can all see me. See, this is what God does in your life. I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me. I can jump, I can run, I can do everything. And God is so awesome, my beloved. If you do not have faith, you will never receive anything. I just want to encourage each one of you. Because of Jesus Christ, I stand before you. You know, be humble. Accept every correction in life. Let it be even a child correcting you, because God uses everyone. Love one another. What do you get by hating or speaking or hurting one another? Nothing. The love of Christ should be in you to overcome everything in you. Amen. I really want to thank even Pastor Bhavesh. Of course, I never knew this. I don't know if I knew it, whether I would have been here. Okay? And everyone of GR Dubai Church. It's such a great privilege for me to see and experience your love.
Love you, Mommy.
Yeah, I love you more than words can speak. But more overall, I really tell you, G Jesus' love is so genuine. Do you love Jesus? Today, if you look at me, and you can see I'm 70 long years old, but for me, Christ lives in me, I feel I'm only 33 years old. The day I'm going home, I will be 33 years old. But till that time, I keep living only 30 and 33, okay? Are you going to follow that?
Yes!
Really, it's such a great privilege, and I really thank the Lord. Because the truth is, when I was praying last time about so many things, God showed me when He's going to take me home. Okay? I know it. God told me, I will renew your strength, but I will not let you suffer. If you ever suffer, I will take you home because I love you. This is what I heard from the Lord. I did share it with one, two of my family, children and my family, but this is what God is all about. If you experience the true love of Jesus and give your total life and surrender your life into His hands, believe me, brothers and sisters, there's nothing that we shall ever fear. Because living or dying in Christ is glory for Him, and eternity is going to be with Jesus. I still keep praying for each one of you all. And you know, sometimes it's only Jesus who knows you. He has made you, no matter what your past was. Okay, now I'm going to just give you one small clue. When before you became a believer, Jesus said, I've thrown your sins as far as the east is from the west. Amen? But after you got water baptized and you confessed Jesus and your Lord and Savior, never sin, my beloved. That is the secret of it all. We are human beings, might be sometimes with, I would not say even accidentally, because when Jesus lives in you, He convicts you every time. Do not sin. Even if it's small, ask God's pardon. That is the glory and the secret of God's word. And believe me, I have been in this church with the body of Christ, and I really tell you, God has hidden many secrets in His Bible. If you want to be a friend of God, again I say a friend of God, He only reveals it to His friends who He can trust. Amen. Amen? Although Peter denied Jesus, right? In the beginning. But still Jesus knew he could trust Him. That's why He said, feed my sheep, tend my sheep. Right? The same way, my beloved, we all ought to know who Jesus is in our life. Amen? Do not fool yourself. We cannot put on a mask on our face and walk through this world when we sin. Amen? We should really reconcile back to the Father, because eternity is with Him. Life is so unpredictable today. Right? So all I can tell you, I love you with the love of the Lord. I thank Pastor Bhavesh and Pastor Lito and Pastor Annie and all the media teams and all the members of GR Dubai community. And I take great privilege in thanking Pastor Mark and Sister Alice. You know, there is nothing to go and ask somebody for prayer. My secret is whenever I feel down or anything and Pastor Mark comes around, I always go because he is, God has appointed him as head shepherd. I go and ask him very, very simply, Pastor Mark, can you please pray for me? Yes, Mama Lynn, I love to pray for you, and he prays. My beloved, we love each other. We share everything with each other. Amen. Never let pride rule you. Amen. Never, never. We are all equal. If it's only what you have in you, can you give the world? If you don't have it in you, you can't give the world. So let love be seen. We ask God today to multiply the love in our lives, that we will all glorify Him as one big family. And I thank you all very much, all you pastors, the BOE and everyone, for making this occasion of my birthday, which I never celebrated, so grand. And I really tell you, when I walked in, I was shocked, but I could feel the presence of God. And I could feel that Jesus was just saying, I love you, I love you. And I was overjoyed. Believe me, God is so good. Thank you once again, church. I love you with the love of the Lord, and I keep praying for you. Do pray for me as well. Love you.
We love you, Mommy, with the love of the Lord. Can we give a clap again to our living God? Praise God. Mommy, we soar high like an eagle. Amen. Praise God. by the goodness of God. Now, we already seen that the body of Christ and Board of Elders and Gia Dubai Church already declared goodness in the life of Mami Lynn. Now, the youth, the younger hearts are overwhelmed with this goodness of God. So are the children. Amen. So, we have prepared something for you, Mommy, and we pray that you, everyone will enjoy this. Amen. The lovely kids. Amen. Praise God. Can we give them a clap, please? I got to see them.
Go, Lenny!
I know he's feeling out of town.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the life of our brother, Lord. Thank you, God, that you have bestowed your love. And more important, God, that he has known you in this life that he has, you have given. As he celebrates his 50th birthday, Lord, we pray, may your blessings be upon him. May your strength be upon him. May your beginning, the new beginning in the 50, will start as something very big in his life, oh Lord. And we pray your peace, joy, always rule in his life, and your wisdom will be upon him, Lord. And we speak good health, and we pray that may he win souls for your kingdom till he has the last breath, Lord. We bless him, God. We pray, God, that as we celebrate with him, this is the celebration of every one of us here. We celebrate, Lord. Thank you once again for his life. We bless him. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So, before we take a thanks, you can be seated, right? Because I just wanted to say thanks to the 17 team who has put all this together. I just created a group and I told them that we need to do something for Naomi's birthday. And then they came out with all the plans. I said, do whatever you want, let's do it. And let's give her the best gift that we can give it to her, right? Amen. So we are so blessed. And first of all, I'd like to thank to all of the body of Christ who came, GIA Dubai, all the region pastors who are here, all the board elders, all the youths and the children who came. You know, we feel that we are a family, right? We never feel that we are not alone, right? And thank you once again for taking your time. But you will be giving a very simple dinner after this. Everyone need to eat. Those who will not eat, they will pay the price. Who will pay the whole thing for it, right? That's why everyone needs to eat. Everyone needs to be put the food. And whenever you eating it, remember, and also remember as you came, always to pray for mommy in your prayer. Keep her in your prayer daily. Remember her daily in your prayer. Amen? And we are so grateful and thankful for what God is doing and what God is continuing to do. But just wanted to say one beautiful story about mommy. You might be thinking that sometimes she looks very strange, or sometimes Vishu looks very stubborn, sometimes she looks very angry, right? Sometimes you misunderstand her. How many people have misunderstood mommy? Come on, be honest here, okay? How many people misunderstood when you first see and first approach of her in your life? How many people? Come on, raise your hand. Okay? Everyone has this misunderstanding approach. Right? Just want to tell you, she is a very strong when it comes to ethics, disciplines, and many things in her life. We have been raised by that way. You know, when Mommy Lynn comes from the work and she says, children, and she will start calling our name, we will run one by one on the second floor because our house is on second floor and straight inside the house. 8 o'clock we need to eat food, 8:30 need to pray, 9 o'clock on the bed. But now Mommy is changed. Right? Now Mommy is changed. Right? Now because before she never used to give us the food in the night, but now I tell Mom I'm hungry 1:30 in the morning, and she will look and she will prepare something and give it to you. The story belongs to it. Mommy has dedicated her life after her husband lost. Even though she was not a believer that time, but she has dedicated her life to serve people. She has dedicated. Whenever she goes to India, when the people come to know that she's there, every day the guest keeps coming in the house to meet her. I remember the story of an auto rickshaw driver. And he came home, he was crying, and we were here, and I learned the charity, how she does, I learned from her. He came, he was crying and asking, Mommy, can you give us 20,000 rupees? I'm talking about those days, and I was hearing. She asked, what happened? My wife need to go an operation, and she has this problem, and the doctor said, if you will not operate her, she will have this kind of. She said, how much, which doctor she interviewed? And she said, no worry. Morning, the first train that leaves from our station, she said, we will go. And she took that lady, took that auto rickshaw driver, and she went to the government hospital in Bombay, which is JJ Hospital, and she paid only 2 rupees for that operation. Wow. Wow. Getting it? Only 2 rupees. Because she will dedicate the life. She has already dedicated a lot of children, a lot of poor people in her place. Even till today, you may be very surprised. She has a set of friends. She has a set of widows with her. And whatever support that we give, whatever she gets, I have seen she is sending to these widows, that friends they have in India. Yeah? Mommy is a very gracious woman. She has been very disciplined in everything. But the one thing she doesn't like in this area, when we murder her English. When we speak wrong English, when we murder the English, she gets very annoyed. And she also, when she came here, and when she started to speak in the 2-3 years time, even my English language, the way I was speaking in India was changed. And when she came here, she said, what happened to your English? I said, now Mama, your English also will be the same because you have a people who speak this kind of English. Okay? So, wonderful story she has, a lot of things she has. She lost her elder sister recently. We also remember that even on the day that she was doing the first, I believe it was the first women's convention that she was doing, the day only her brother also lost. And we were surprised. Now we have Ate Joy here. Ate Joy knows Mama Lin's husband, Kuyamarsi knew that Mama Lin's brother, because they were all working in the same company. And when I talked to Kuyamarsi about it, he was surprised that Mama Lin's the sister of the one who established one of the companies that they are all working in. And even two brothers of Mama Lin, who are working here. She has a lot of family members here in UAE, she has a lot of friends here, but she has dedicated her life for us here. Okay? So I just wanted to take this opportunity and say thank you, Mommy, for the life that you have shared with us, right? Thank you, everyone. You can say thank you, Mommy, the life that she has shared with us, right? Tirelessly she works, right? She's the first one to get up in the house, and she was the last one to go in the bed, right? Tirelessly she works. She enjoys the ministry. She enjoys everything that we're doing. So we pray that you will always remember in our prayer. Every day, just offer a 20-second of prayer. When you remember Mommy Lin, just offer a 20-second prayer to Jesus, that Jesus will keep her always healthy. Always healthy, right? She mentioned something, I don't know whether you're able to got it. She said, God has spoken to her, God will prolong the life. The moment she will be gets anything happen, God will take her. When she has a already instruction from the Holy Spirit, what will be the future she will be. Yesterday night when we were celebrating, she also mentioned the same thing. She said, I'm ready. Lord, don't make me suffer and go on this world. If you want to take me, just one quick. That I sleep or might get a headache and I'm died. Right? This will only happen when you understand the love of God in your life. When you understand eternity in your life. Right? Because the love of God removes every fear from her life. And she lives fearlessly when it comes to those things. Right? So God bless you all. Thank you very much. Enjoy the evening together. When we are meeting outside and we're dining together, meet each other, right? Talk to each other and don't forget that. Amen? So I'll give it back to her.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Church, will you please stand up? And I would like to call our dear pastora, Pastor Alice, to close us in prayer.
Praise the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. My beloved Mommy Lynn, I love you. And I know everybody loves you also. Happy, happy birthday, my dear Mommy Lynn, from GL Northern Emirates. We love you and happy 70th birthday. Ah, 33rd birthday. Sorry, sorry. Happy 33rd birthday. Praise God and may the Lord's blessings be upon you always. Amen? So, lahat kayo gutom na. Okay? Kaya ako pinili nyo para mabilis. So, praise the Lord. Sige, let's thank the Lord for His goodness. Let's bow our head and let's pray. Heavenly Father, oh Lord, You are awesome in this place. You are great, oh Lord. We praise You. We praise You, oh Lord God Almighty. We thank You, Lord, for Your goodness, for Your greatness, oh God. Thank You, Father, for the life of our beloved Mommy Lynn, oh Lord. Salamat, Panginoon, sa iyong kabutihan sa kanyang buhay, oh God. We thank You, Lord, for Your anointing, oh God. Anointing to truthfulness and greatness, oh God, to all of us in GIA community and to the body of Christ. Thank You, Father, for the unity, for the love, oh Lord. Salamat, Panginoon, sa kabutihan mo. So, Father, we give You all the glory and honor, oh God, tonight. Thank You for Thy presence, oh God. And thank You, Father, for giving us more blessings, oh God. Thank You for the food, oh Lord, that we're going to partake, oh Lord. Sanctify this food, oh God. And, Father, continue to bless us, oh God. And bless us abundantly, oh God, so that we may be a blessing to many nations, oh God. Not only in UAE, but Lord, beyond this country, Panginoon, even in Africa, Panginoon, sa Middle East, at kung saan man kami gustong dalhin. Thank You, Father, for the unity in the Spirit. Thank You, Father, for GIA Community UAE and for the body of Christ, oh God. Lord, we give You all the thanks. We give You all the glory and honor to Your name alone, oh God. In Jesus' name, Lord, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
For Him, He rewards me, 'cause He loves me.
it's real when I look down, down, down. I believe what I found. When I look in God's word and I search for Him, He rewards me.